All right. Hi, Sophie here. Let's dive right in. Let's set this up as if we're opening Blender for the first time. New 2D animation file. And first thing is to hold shift while you drag on the corner of any window to make it pop out. I'm gonna quickly resize it and then change the editor type to image editor and set the image as the render result. Next, to make our render image actually render in this box, go into Edit, Preferences. We're already in interface where we need to be, so open the dropdown for temporary editors and have it render in the image editor. Now, when we press F12, it will render in this window without opening anything else. Though note that if you do not have an image editor already open somewhere, then it will transform one of the current workspaces into the image editor. You could alternately make any one of these workspaces the image editor, or even split a workspace in half to turn one of them into the image editor. I just personally really enjoy having a floating window. I can minimize it, and then when I render again, it will pop back up. And unlike the usual window that pops up when you render, this window will stay on top of your screen while you keep working and drawing in your scene. All of this is just my personal preference, by the way, and will not necessarily be the best method for everyone. So then I go into the compositing workspace, check on Use Nodes, and in between these two, I add an RGB to BW node. And then in Output Properties here, I like to change the render percentage to about 20 to 30. So I'll hide this top layer for this next example. So when I open my blend files to work on them, I like to immediately hit F12 to render, and then I click on this render window and press J to toggle a new image state. And then as I keep working, I continually render into this new window so that if I press back on this window, I can use J to toggle between the two render results to see exactly what changes I've made since I started working on this piece. Boom, tutorial done. Technical part out of the way, if that's all you're here for. But of course, this wouldn't be my channel if I didn't spend the next few minutes talking about why. Why do I do this? Why do I love this trick so much? Let's start with what I have very creatively called the J trick. One of the ways that this helps me is when I'm deep in the rendering process. We're talking inching along the canvas, adding very small strokes here and there. It can feel like I'm not making any progress, and it is so satisfying to be able to toggle back to what my piece looked like when I first opened the blend file and see how far I've come. This is similar in a way to creating a new layer each time you open the file, which you can then toggle on and off to see the progress. But my process involves a lot of going back to previous layers and modifying the strokes on those layers. And so that wouldn't accurately capture all the changes that I had made. So it's motivating. But another way it benefits me is that it helps me to realize, before it's too late, when I'm starting to go in the wrong direction. All right, it's been a few days of sitting on this because I don't love how I expressed this next part the first time, and I've been trying to think of what it was that I wanted to say, but I guess really, it just comes down to this black and white window that is perpetually open, updated every few minutes of working on the piece, and visible no matter how much I zoom in or out. I think the risk with rendering is getting so caught up in the little details. I don't know, getting the fur textures just so, getting a single value transition just right, or capturing the exact color I want. Getting so lost in small areas of the piece that I lose sight of the image as a whole. I'm still new to my art journey and learning as much as I can, but something I've really been focusing on is having my pieces read clearly from a distance and in black and white. I think values really carry the weight of a painting, and this is especially important for me, because I love going ridiculous with my color choices. I like saturated colors probably too much.
It's definitely a choice and a preference, but I also think that my pieces work because the values are clear and the different shapes that make up the images read well even on a small scale. And so having this box up, that's what it helps me to keep an eye on, to make sure that I'm not losing those distinct values, the separation of light and dark that gives things form, or the simple shapes that make up my piece and getting overly complex, which can actually weaken the message, the clear, simple message of what it is you're drawing. So in all of the refilming, I totally lost any sort of transition to this next part, and it now seems way too out of the blue, so Transition. I have something really exciting to talk about. I just launched a Patreon. Any support goes a really long way to helping me to keep making art and videos. There's some really cool stuff over there, and I just posted 8 hours worth of real-time footage covering the entire process of making this commission piece in Blender. I hope you'll check it out. Join if you're able to, and if you want to. You can find me all over the internet at Sophie Jantak. Thanks for being here. However you choose to support me, I really appreciate it. But I will talk to you again very soon. Take care. Bye.